it was not what we were told the Americans were, American soldiers were. Like, you know, there was a scare, quite a bit of scare during the wartime and so forth, to beef up the anti-U.S. feeling and so forth. You can never have the Americans on Japanese soil, because all the Japanese males will be castrated, and all the females, you know, they will be turned into you know, the those kind of things, you know, bad things. But it was not so. If once the U.S. soldiers started coming around, yeah, very generous, and a very you know, person with a deep heart inside. Yes. Because when I was going to school and so forth, and the National Higher School and so forth, we visited a British, you know, especially in Okinawa area, there was a British and Australians and the American soldiers. But one of the soldiers had the Bible study at his own residence and so forth, things like that. And gradually learned about what was taught about the Westerners, American and British and so forth, completely different. Not like what we were taught to believe in. I don't think in general it took very long. Of course, there are incidents like what happened in Brazil and so forth, you know, the Kachigumi and Makegumi, the winners team and the defeating teams and so forth, things like that. But that was more or less isolated. And I think as far as the PR, US PR and so forth, was very good, worked very effectively. So that it didn't take very long for the Japanese to change their thinking, to discover what was what wrong they were being taught to believe in, and so forth. I don't think it took very long.